Welcome to the Principles of Management course, week two. Today I look forward to presenting the SWOT analysis to you. The SWOT analysis stands for strengths, weaknesses, threats, and opportunities. The way in which we gather information is from discussions and meetings, from the external and internal environment, also reports and essays that have been written. So I look forward to sharing Life Pacific College's example of their SWOT analysis, which was produced 5 years ago. About every 5 years, an organization gets together and they begin to facilitate and prepare a SWOT analysis for the various constituency groups. So I'm going to provide, we're going to look at the strengths first, and I want you to concentrate primarily on the bullets that are bold so I can get through this presentation more quickly. Here we're going to first start by looking at the bullets on the left-hand side, which is the internal constituencies and those who are involved directly with Life Pacific College, anyone from the leadership, faculty, staff, and students, and then the external constituents the right side of this presentation would be those who are highly invested in Life Pacific College, such as community leaders and individuals from the Four Squares denomination. So if we were to look at the strengths internally, there's a perception that we have a very strong community who has common values and a common belief system. We are also a debt-free organization, and we are regionally and nationally accredited. Those are all very important things. The external constituent groups, such as the Four Square denomination, believe that we have a sense of family, that we are a faith-based organization. They also acknowledge that we have strong leadership and a very active board. So now I'm going to take a look at our opportunities. And internally, those involved in the organization have a perception that we need to develop undergraduate programs to help students prepare for bivocational ministry. And we also need to work on marketing our current programs from other charismatic churches, such as the Assemblies of God denomination or the Pentecostal Church of God denomination. And then moving to our external constituency, they also resonate with the internal constituencies in that they believe we need to recruit outside the Four Squares denomination. So moving to our next area, which is looking at the weaknesses internally, the perception overall is that we need to be more involved in our local community. And then if we were to look at the external constituents, they believe that we could be doing a little bit better job marketing the Life Pacific College's educational programs. Now keep in mind, this was 5 years ago, and we've made a lot of progress in 5 years. So I want to now look at the threats, and it's very important to know those. And the threat, of course, internally, we know that we have a lot of competition. There's many other faith-based organizations that we compete against. And then, of course, and this is simply, clearly understandable in that the denomination wants to make sure that we keep a ministry focus with the other bivocational programs that we offer as well as we'll be offering in the future. So I'm so excited to share that information with you. This will link directly into your assignment for week two, and I'm going to work through that with each of you. And so you have a team assignment where I will break you up into groups of two and three, and you will select an organization. It can be one of your organizations. It can be a coffee shop, a yogurt shop, an eating establishment, and you will begin to learn about their strengths and weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. And so I'm looking at step two, and one of the first things that you will do as a team is you will look at the business that you select as a group, their current strategy. Then in step three, you're going to look at the customer's perspective with respect to the strengths and weaknesses. So I would formulate one slide listing out their strengths and another slide listing out the organization's weaknesses. And then in step four, you will look at the potential opportunities and threats of the business, and then again list out the opportunities and the threats. I'm moving over to step 5, and at this point you're going to interview a business owner, a manager, an assistant manager, and you will ask them their perceptions of their strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats, and then you'll add information to that list. And then lastly, you're going to organize your information as a team. You will present one PowerPoint. The PowerPoint should be at least 5 slides, but no longer than 8 slides. And be sure to put your names on the PowerPoint. So I should receive a total of 3 PowerPoints, 1 PowerPoint per team, and put your names on that so I know how to credit you. So I hope this is a great experience. I wanted to share the theory of SWOT analysis, and now you have an opportunity to practice that. I wish you the very best. May God bless all of you, and I look forward to seeing you next week.